السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Friends, welcome to my channel Arabic Made Easy for All. Friends, in today's video, we will be learning how to use the personal pronouns of Arabic in sentences. كيف نستخدم الضمائر المنفصلة في الجمل. So let us start. Friends, the personal pronouns of Arabic are separate for masculine, separate for feminine, and separate for third person, separate for first person, and separate for second persons also. So friends, this is a unique feature of Arabic language that we use the personal pronouns, even the verbs also and the nouns also or adjective, separate for masculine and separate for feminine. This is a unique feature of Arabic, and that also separate for singular, dual, and plural, except in some cases that I will explain. So friends, these are the personal pronouns. First is hua, huma, hum. Is singular, dual, plural. Hua, huma, hum. He, they both, they all. And these three are for male, that is for masculine. Singular, dual, plural. These three are for female. Third person, female, third person. Hiya, huma, hunna. Hiya, huma, hunna. She, they both, they all. For second person masculine, it is anta, anta, antuma, antum. Anta, antuma, antum. You both, you all. And for feminine, anti, antuma, antunna. Anti, antuma, antunna. You both, you all. And for the first person, masculine and feminine. So these two, singular, ana, nahnu, and nahnu. Ana is used for singular, male and female both. Nahnu is used for dual and plural for both male and female, masculine and feminine. It is ana, nahnu. Ana, nahnu. I, we. I gave here two to show you that dual and plural are both same. Friends, I made here some notes, very important notes about how to use the personal pronouns of Arabic in sentences and what instructions or what points we should take care. First thing, pronouns are used in place of the actual nouns. Okay, this is one point. These pronouns are used in place of the actual nouns. Pronouns must be used separate for masculine nouns and feminine nouns. This is one thing, very important. Next is, pronouns must be used singular, dual, and plural according to the number of the nouns or subjects. So you must take care whether the subject for which you are using the personal pronouns is singular, dual, or plural, masculine or feminine. According to that, you have to use singular feminine noun pronoun. Singular feminine pronoun is used for the plural noun of the non-intelligent or non-living things. It means if the noun for which you are going to use the personal pronouns is a non-intelligent or non-living thing, then you can use the singular feminine noun, third person. That is here, that you can use for such things, singular. No need to use the plural. Both are allowed, both can be used, but better we can use the singular form. Personal pronouns are subjects, and the next part is the predicate in a nominal sentence. So friends, when there is a nominal sentence in which the personal pronouns are used, that means the personal pronoun will be considered as subject, and the next part will be the predicate. The predicate must be indefinite, except otherwise it is a proper noun. So that means the predicate which comes after the pronoun in a sentence must be indefinite noun without alif and lam. Otherwise, if the noun is proper noun, then there is no issue. There is no issue. Okay, and then the next point is the predicate should be double dhamma, tanween of dhamma, or single dhamma at the last letter. It means the predicate should have double dhamma at the last letter if there is no alif and lam, and single dhamma in case there is alif and lam, or if the noun is ghair munsarif, then it will have only single dhamma. Otherwise, it is predicate. The predicate must be indefinite and with double dhamma. In case the predicate is the sound masculine plural, then it must be in the nominative case. Friends, actually, in nominative case, and that is with waw and noon. In fact, in Arabic, there are three cases. Okay, three cases of nouns in a sentence. One is nominative, one is objective or accusative, and one is genitive. So, in this case, where subject and predicate are there, the form of the masculine noun should be nominative case. That means with waw and noon. I will show you the examples at the end of this slides. The next point is, in the sentence, if the subject, the pronoun is singular, dual or plural, the predicate must be the same. That means the noun, the pronouns or the nouns and predicate must match in number, gender and person. Number, gender and person. That means if the noun or the subject is singular, predicate should be singular. If it is dual, the predicate should be dual. If it is plural, the predicate should be plural. If it is feminine, the predicate should be feminine. If it is masculine, the predicate should be masculine. That is what it meant here. For the first person, the predicate must be used masculine or feminine, dual or plural, accordingly. That means what I said you, I, Anna. Anna is used for male and female, both singular. Nahnu is used for dual and plural, both for male and female. Let us see the next. Friends, I have given here use of the personal pronouns. Use of the personal pronouns. So you can see here, I have given the examples like huwa. Huwa rajulun. Huwa rajulun. He is a man. Huma rajulani. They both are men. So you can see here, this is subject, this is predicate. This is subject, this is predicate. And I told you there should be double dhamma here. And you can see this is double dhamma. And then here, huma rajulani. This is for singular. They both are men. So you can see this is dual. So here also dual. To make dual in Arabic, we use alif and noon at the last of the noun. So as you can see here, rajulani. Noon with kasra. Okay, then hum rijalun, they all are men. They all are men. So rijalun is plural, and you can see here double dhamma. So friends, this is for third person feminine, and it is hiya, huma, hunna. Hiya, huma, hunna. And examples are hiya bintun. Hiya bintun. She is a girl. Huma bintani. They both are girls. Hunna banatun. And they all are girls. So you can see here in the first one, that is singular. And the second one, it is dual. And this one is plural. So as the pronoun is plural, so the predicate is also plural. This is second person, anta, antuma, antum. Second person masculine, anta shagirun, you are small. Antuma or you are young. Antuma Sagirane, you both are young. Antum Sigarun, you all are young. So you can see here, here also both are matching. Next. For first person, second person feminine, sorry, for second person feminine, Anti Antuma Antumna Anti Sagiratun. There it was Anti Anta Sagirun, Sagirun, that is for male, and here it is Sagiratun. You can see here this Tamarbuta, it is for feminine. So Anti Sagiratun, Antuma Sagiratani, Antuna Sagiratun. You are young, you both are young, you all are young. So you can see here singular, dual, and plural for second person feminine. For first person, male and female, ana, nahnu, nahnu. Ana sagirun or sagiratun. I am young, boy or girl, both can be said, when can be used. Nahnu sagirane, sagiratane. We both, male or female, are young. Nahnu sigarun, sagiratun. We all are young or young, both for male and female can be used. Friends, I told you about the sound masculine plural, and it is here. Sound masculine plural, these nouns are sound masculine plural. You can see here, we actually can say Muslimuna or Muslimina. Muslimuna and Muslimina, but we have to use with waw and noon because it is a nominative case. So hum Muslimun, antum Mudarrisun, you can see it is plural with all plural male sound masculine plural. So hum antum nahnu, hum antum nahnu. Okay, so Muslimun, they all are Muslims, you all are teachers. We all are players, they all are travelers, you all are engineers, we all are laborious, mujtahiduna, laborious. So these all noun used here as sound masculine plural. So in this case, you have to use with waw and noon. So friend, this is the video for today. I hope that you understood today's video and wish that it will help you in learning Arabic. Thank you very much for watching my video.